Situation. After passing the nurse licensure examination, Nurse Caridad takes her first job in a rural health unit in Municipality Z. She reviews the concepts and principles in primary health care. Okay, so question number 127. The key global agency that initiated the Alma-Ata Conference on Primary Health Care is the A. World Bank, B. World Health Organization, C. The CARE International, or D. United Nations Children's Fund, or the UNICEF. Okay, so take note, in question number 127, the question here is the key global agency that initiated the Alma-Ata Conference on PHC. Okay, so take note that the first Alma-Ata Declaration happens on September 6-12, 1978. That is the first international conference on PHC on Almaty, Kazakhstan, or sa USSR, Russia. So, mag-eliminate tayo ng option dito. Tatanggalin natin dito yung letter A, which is the World Bank and the CARE International. Kasi wala naman po silang kinalaman sa ating primary health care, okay? So, take note that the World Health Organization is the one who sponsored the Alma-Ata Conference or the Alma-Ata Declaration. And it was organized by both the UNICEF and the WHO. Pero since ang tinatanong ay the key global agency that initiated the Alma-Ata Conference on PHC, the correct answer here is letter B. It is the World Health Organization. So letter B is the key global agency that initiated the Alma-Ata Conference on Primary Healthcare. Okay? So the correct answer here is the World Health Organization. The conference was organized by the World Health Organization and the UNICEF. Conference on Primary Health Care was held in Alma-Ata, USSR, or now known as the Almaty, Kazakhstan. The Declaration of Alma-Ata is co-sponsored by the World Health Organization, is a brief document that expresses the need for urgent action by all governments, all health and development workers, and the world community to protect and promote the health of all people of the world. The next, number 128, which Asian country is considered among the first to adopt the principles of primary health care? Okay, so the question here is the first Asian country to adopt the principles of primary health care. So A, Malaysia, B, Indonesia, C, Thailand, or D, Philippines. Okay, so alin dito yung pinakaunang nag-adopt ng principles of PHC? So take note, the first Alma-Ata Conference was on September 6-12, 1978. So in year 1979, inadopt na ng Pilipinas. So the first Asian country to adopt the principles of PHC is the Philippines. Okay, so letter D is the correct answer here. So the Philippines claims to be one of the first, perhaps sila nga talaga ang first, countries to have adopted PHC as the national strategy for healthcare. And it since in 1981, there is an impressive achievement that have been attained in the sector by contrast with reversals in many other sectors of the economy. So the PHC in the Philippines was adopted through the letter of instruction 949 signed by President Ferdinand Marcos on October 19, 1979. So that is the legal basis of the primary healthcare in the Philippines, the adaptation of the PHC in the Philippines signed by Ferdinand Marcos, the LOI 949. Okay? So, the first Asian country to adopt the PHC principle is no other than the Philippines. Okay, so letter D is the correct answer. Okay, so question number 129. Nurse Caridad is aware that she has to use the tools and methods that all suitable and acceptable to the families and communities that she serves. This PHC principle is referred to as A. Cultural application, B. Appropriate technology, C. Essential methodology, or D. Community participation. Okay? So, keyword in your question number 129, PHC principle, which is defined as the tools and methods that are suitable and acceptable to the families and communities. Okay? Keyword is suitable and acceptable to the families and communities. So, alin daw dito yung term na yon, or ano yung PHC principle po yung ating nire-refer dito? Cultural application, appropriate technology, essential methodology, or community participation. Okay? So, dalawa lang naman dyan yung ating PHC principle. We have appropriate technology and community participation. So, the correct answer here is letter B. It is all about your appropriate technology. Because if we say appropriate technology, it is the term that refers to the methods, the procedures, the techniques, and equipment that are scientifically valid and adapted to local needs and acceptable to those who use them, and to those for whom they are used, and that can be maintained and utilized with the resources that the community or country can afford. So, for the tools and methods that are suitable and acceptable to the families and communities, that is the appropriate technology. So, the correct answer here is letter B. Okay, the next question, number 130. Nurse Caridad recognizes that health services offered are to be in accordance to the prevailing beliefs and practices of the intended clients of care. This PHC principle is known as A. Availability, B. Acceptability, C. Affordability, or D. Accessibility. Okay, so ano po ito? The services must be in accordance to the prevailing beliefs and practices of the intended clients of care. So, this PHC principle is known as the acceptability, letter B. Kasi, it should be in accordance to the prevailing beliefs and practices daw. So, that is acceptable, PHC. Kasi, pag sinabi po nating availability, the care can be obtained whenever people need it. So, pagdating naman kay affordability, meron po siyang kinalaman sa presyo or sa cost ng services or ng ating care. So, in your affordability, the cost should be within the means and within the resources of the individual and the community. So, abot-kaya dapat ang presyo. Or, o di kaya, sa ating affordability, low-cost services po tayo. So, take note, in your primary healthcare, the services there are not free. Okay? Not totally free po yan. So, meron po siyang affordability means. Okay? The next, pag sinabi naman kasi nating accessibility, the essential and appropriate health services are available to the citizens within a reasonable geographic distance. So, kailangan not more than 5 kilometers away and not more than 30 minutes to travel yung ating health services or yung ating mga health facilities. Okay? And it should be in within a time frame that is appropriate. And if we say acceptability, health services offered are to be in accordance to the prevailing beliefs and practices of the intended clients of care. It should not be against with their prevailing beliefs and practices. Para masabi natin na ito ay acceptable primary health care. Okay? So, the correct answer here in your number 130 is letter B, acceptability. Okay, the next question, number 131. Collaboration and cooperation is crucial to the achievement of the primary health care goals. The referral system among the RHU, non-government organization, and the local social welfare and development office is classified as what type of relationship? A. Intersectoral collaboration, B. Coalition building, C. Intersectoral collaboration, or D. Network linkages. Okay? So, ano pong tawag natin dito sa ating collaboration, cooperation between between the community to the RHU and the non-government organization and local social welfare and development? So, ang tawag po natin dyan sa relationship na yan is the intersectoral collaboration. Letter C po yan. Kasi kung titingnan natin sa choices natin, there are two opposing options, letter A and letter C. Intersectoral yung letter A, ang letter C naman is intersectoral. So, the correct answer here is the intersectoral collaboration. Kasi pag sinabi natin intersectoral collaboration, it refers to the promotion and coordination of activities of different sectors of the healthcare system to enhance and to provide qualitative services to the community. So, collaboration and cooperation is crucial to the achievement of PHC goals. So, in terms of your collaboration between the RHU, non-government organization, and the local social welfare and development office, that is classified as intersectoral collaboration. So, letter C is the correct answer. Okay, so next situation. The World Health Organization or the WHO have been identified different factors that cause non-communicable diseases that threatens millions of people's health and countries' economic and social development. Okay, so question number 132. What are the four chronic diseases that the WHO have cited? Number 1, cardiovascular disease. Number 2, cancer. Number 3, dementia. Number 4, arthritis. Number 5, diabetes mellitus. Or number 6, chronic obstructive lung disease. So, sa option A natin, 1, 2, 3, and 4 daw. So, cardiovascular disease, cancer, dementia, and arthritis daw. Letter B, cardiovascular disease, cancer, diabetes mellitus, and chronic obstructive lung disease. Or letter C, cancer, dementia, arthritis, and diabetes mellitus. Or letter D, cancer, arthritis, diabetes mellitus, and chronic obstructive lung disease. So, alin po dito yung mga four chronic diseases that the WHO have cited? So, by definition, pag sinabi po natin chronic diseases are defined broadly as conditions that last 6 months or 1 year or more and require ongoing medical attention or limit activities of daily living or both. So, the most common chronic diseases cited by the WHO are the heart diseases, cancer, diabetes, and the chronic obstructive lung disease. And these are the leading causes of death and disability in the whole world. Okay? So, tandaan po natin, the four chronic diseases that have been cited by the WHO are the cardiovascular diseases, cancer, diabetes mellitus, and the chronic obstructive lung disease. So, that is 1, 2, 5, and 6. So, the correct answer here is letter B. Letter B, 1, 2, 5, and 6. Okay, so it's your cardiovascular disease, cancer, diabetes mellitus, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Okay, so next, number 133. According to the WHO, what is the worldwide number one cause of death from chronic diseases determined through the 2015 estimate? So, take note, ang hinahanap po natin dito is the number one cause of death from chronic diseases 2015 estimate. Okay? So, letter A, tuberculosis. Letter B, diabetes mellitus. Letter C, ischemic heart disease. Or D, pneumonia. So, alin po dito ang nanguna noong 2015? So, ano dito ang pangunahing sanhi ng kamatayan sa chronic diseases noong 2015? Is it tuberculosis, diabetes mellitus, ischemic heart disease, or pneumonia? Okay? So, in your number 133, the correct answer here is letter C. Ischemic heart disease po yan. Okay? So, take note that the world's biggest, okay, the world's biggest killer is the ischemic heart disease. And it is responsible for the 16% of the world's total deaths, okay? So, the number one killer or cause of death among chronic diseases is the ischemic heart disease. So, the correct answer here is letter C. So, according to the WHO or the World Health Organization 2016 data, the following are the top 10 causes of death in the descending order. Descending order po yan. So, number one po talaga ang ischemic heart disease, followed by number two, stroke. Number 3, COPD or the chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Number 4, the lower respiratory infections. Number 5, the Alzheimer's disease and other dementias. Number 6, trachea, bronchos, and lung cancers. And number 7, diabetes mellitus. Number 8, road injury. Number 9, diarrheal diseases. And number 10, tuberculosis. Okay, so yung TB ay pang-sampo. Okay, so the correct answer here is letter C, ischemic heart disease. So, number one po yan. Nanguna po yan noong 2016 estimate ng WHO. Okay, so question number 134. Referring to the Department of Health's data in 2009, what is the top killer in the Philippines? A. Asthma, B. Cancer, C. Tuberculosis, or D. Cardiovascular disease. So, kung kanina ay 2016 estimate, top killer globally is the ischemic heart disease. Ano naman kaya ang ating top killer in the Philippines according to the DOH data in 2009? Okay? So, A, asthma ba yan? B, cancer? C, tuberculosis? Or D, cardiovascular disease? Okay? So, take note that in your Department of Health's data in 2009, the top killer still is the cardiovascular diseases. So, letter D is the correct answer. Okay? So, dog po ang tamang sagot. So, according to the Department of Health in 2005 to 2009 data on deaths, it revealed that the following are the top 10 causes of death in descending order. So, number 1 pa rin yung ating diseases of the heart or the cardiovascular diseases. Number 2, diseases of the vascular system. Number 3 na top killer is the malignant neoplasm or cancer. So, yung cancer is pangatlo lang po yan. Number 4 is pneumonia. Number 5 is accident. Number 6 is the tuberculosis, and number 7 is the chronic lower respiratory diseases. Number 8 is the diabetes mellitus. Number 9 is the nephritis, nephrotic syndrome, and nephrosis, or mga renal diseases natin. And number 10, certain conditions originating in the perinatal period. Okay, so take note, according to the DOH 2005-2009 data on deaths, it reveals that diseases of the heart and diseases of the vascular system or the cardiovascular diseases are still the top killer or the number one cause of death in the Philippines. Okay? So, the correct answer is letter D. Okay, the next question, number 135. What is the implication of considering the multifactorial etiology of illnesses when studying chronic diseases? A. Single organism that causes the disease, such as the cholera. It must be studied in more detail. Letter B, focus should be on the factors or combinations and levels of factors contributing to the disease. Or letter C, the rise in infectious and communicable disease must be the main focus. Or letter D, genetics and molecular structure of the disease is paramount. Okay, so ang tinatanong po dito is the multifactorial etiology of illnesses, okay, when studying your chronic diseases. So, keyword multifactorial, okay? So, anong focus mo? Yung mga factors, okay? Factors that contributing to the disease. So, the correct answer here in your number 135 is letter B, okay? Letter B, focus should be on the factors or combination and level of factors in contributing the disease. Okay? So, pag sinabi kasi natin multifactorial etiology, it implies to the focus on combinations and levels of factors. Kaya siya tinawag na multifactorial etiology. Etiology means the cause. Okay? The origin of the certain disease. So, pag-aralan mo yung origin or mga combinations and levels of factors that causes the disease. So, there are many factors to consider other than only genetics or single organism with multifactorial etiologies. The focus of studying multifactorial etiology is on chronic diseases. So, the correct answer here is letter B. Keyword, multifactorial. So, ano pag-aaralan mo? Yung mga factors that causes the disease. Okay? So, next, number 136, which among the following are determinants of health in addressing the development of cancer in a community? Number 1, proximity of the community to chemical plants that emit poisonous gases. Number 2, high percentage of tobacco use among the residents. And number 3, prevailing diet high in processed food and fats. Number 4, availability of the health facilities. And number 5, men age of women population. So A, 3, 4, and 5. B, 1, 2, and 3. Or C, 1, 3, and 4. Or D, 2, 4, and 5. So alin po dito yung mga determinants of health when addressing the development of cancer in a community, okay? So, number 1, pasok po ba yan? Mga chemical plants or mga planta na nag-emit ng poisonous gases? So, pasok po yan kasi certain gases can cause also cancer or malignancy. Number 2, high percentage of tobacco use among residents. Yes, because tobacco smoking is number 1 factor for the development of certain cancer. And that is example of cancer is the lung cancer or any form of cancer. Tandaan nyo po yan, okay? So, cancer is considered a non-communicable disease, implying that these diseases are not acquired through man-to-man transmission but through exposure to a certain risk factors of cancer, okay? So, ano ba yung mga certain na risk factors na nagkakos ng cancer? So, it may vary from viruses, bacteria, ano pa, mga physical agents, mga chemical agents, the genetic and the familial factors, dietary factors, pasok din po yan para sa mga colorectal cancer and pati yung mga hormonal agents natin, okay? So, of all of the choices above, 1, 2, and 3, all fall under the physical and chemical agents as well as the dietary factor, okay? So, exposure to toxic air pollutants can increase your health risk. For example, if you live near a factory that releases cancer-causing chemicals and you inhale the contaminated air, your risk of getting cancer can be increased. Okay? So, yun po yun. Okay? So, ano ba? Yung tobacco smoking nga, malakas po yan na risk factor for any type of cancer, especially yung mga lung cancers natin. Okay? So, letter B is the correct answer. Okay, so next situation. Promoting mental health is equally important in promoting physical health. Sadly, mental health has been extensively neglected. Okay? So, napaka-importante po ng mental health, especially during this time of pandemic. Okay. So, in your question number 137, Public Health Nurse Monica is concerned about the mental health and preparing for a presentation about mental health in the Philippines. Which of the following information should be included? So, the question is asking for a positive answer kasi positive yung question. Okay, so, alin daw dito yung information na include mo for your presentation about mental health in the Philippines? So, letter A, mental illness is an increased problem among the upper class. Letter B, the incidence of depression is expected to decrease within the next 10 months. Or letter C, almost 1 per 100 household has a member with mental disability. Or letter D, post-traumatic stress disorder is the most common of anxiety disorders. So, which of the following information should be included in your presentation about mental health in the Philippines? A, B, C, or D? Alin dito yung fact or alin dito yung true statement? Okay? So, the correct answer here is letter C. Okay? So, letter C po yan. Why? Because in the Philippines, almost 1 per 100 household or around 0.7% has a member with mental disability. That is according to the DOH SWS survey in 2004. So, as early as 2003, intentional self-harm was already found to be the ninth leading cause of death among 20 to 24-year-old Filipino adults. And that is according to the DOH 2003 data. So, the lifetime risk of major depression is increasing. Hindi po yan pababa. Pataas po yan. Okay? So, mental illness is growing problem throughout the world. So, hindi lang po yung mga upper class ang nagkakaroon ng mental illness or mga mental health problem. So, take note also that in your letter D, mali po yan because it's not your PTSD or the post-traumatic stress disorder ang pinaka-most common na anxiety disorder. Because phobias are the most common anxiety disorder and not PTSD. So, mali po yung ating letter D. Again, ulitin ko, phobia. Phobia po ang number one or most common anxiety disorder and not the PTSD. Okay? So, the correct answer here is letter C. Okay, then next, number 138. The main reason that mental illness often results in worsening of physical health problem is because of the A, loss of cognitive function, B, feelings of inadequacy, C, inability in lack of motivation for effective self-care, or D, side effects of mental health modification. Okay? Or the side effects of mental health medications. So, A, B, C, or D, alin daw dito ang main reason, okay, why that mental illness often results in worsening of physical health problems. So, ibig po sabihin yan, bakit daw kapag meron kang physical health problems ay lalong lumalala kapag nagkakaroon ka ng mental illness. Ano daw ang pinaka-main reason dito? So, is it A, loss of cognitive function? B, feelings of inadequacy? C, inability in lack of motivation for effective self-care? Or D, side effects of mental health modification and medication? So, okay? So, take note that the correct answer here is letter C. Kasi pag meron kang mental illness, nagkaroon po tayo dito ng inability or lack of motivation for effective self-care, okay? So, in general, side effects of your mental health medications do not result in worsening of the physical health problem. So, mali po itong letter D natin. So, in your letter A naman, loss of cognitive function is not a reason that mental illness results in worsening of a physical health problems. And also, in your letter B, the feelings of inadequacy. Okay? So, feelings of inadequacy are not a reason that mental illness results in worsening of the physical health problems. So, the main reason here is due to your inability or lack of motivation for effective self-care, kaya nagkaroon tayo ng worsening of your physical health problems. Okay? That is secondary to mental illness. So, that is the correct answer. So, letter C is the correct answer. Okay, the next question, number 139. Nurse Monica shared the statistics that intentional self-harm was found to be the ninth leading cause of death among 20 to 24 years old Filipino adults. Increasing number of mental health problems may be related to number 1, poverty, number 2, age of the parents, number 3, family unemployment, Number 4, changes in the family structure. And number 5, the loss of community social support. So for letter A, it is 1, 2, and 5, or poverty, age of the parents, and loss of community social support. Or letter B, 1, 3, 4, and 5, or poverty, family unemployment, changes in family structure, and loss of community social support. Or letter C, 1, 2, 3, and 4, or poverty, age of the parents, family unemployment, and changes in family structure. Or letter D, 1, 2, and 3, poverty, age of the parents, and family unemployment. So, alin dito, okay, alin dito ang mga risk factors for developing of your mental health problems. Okay, so, syempre, pasok na dyan yung number 1, poverty. Kasi number 1, poverty is stressful condition, which may increase the number of mental health problems. So, poverty, pasok po yan. So, lahat naman ng choices natin is meron number 1. So, the next, meron din tayo dito ng family unemployment. So, number 3, okay? So, number 3, pasok din ang ating number 3 kasi nga kapag walang trabaho ang isang source of income sa pamilya, stressful po yan and it can cause the increasing number of mental health problems. So, yung number 2 kasi, age of the parents, hindi po yan pasok kasi hindi naman po yan stressful life situation. So, hindi pasok ang mga may number 2. Okay, so the correct answer here is letter B. Okay? Because in your stressful life situations like your family unemployment, changes in the family structures, these are risk factors for developing mental health problems. And also with the lack of community resources like poverty, loss of social community support, it also contributes to the risk of developing your mental illness. So, age of the parent is not a risk factor. It could be history of the mental illness of parents but not the age of the parents. So, letter B is the best answer. Okay, the best answer here is letter B. Okay, the next question, number 140. Nurse Monica noted that there were number of poor older women living alone who are suffering from depression. So, her first goal is to A, improve quality of life, B, provide recreation and entertainment, C, reduce suicide risk, or letter D, improve level of function. So, take note, Nurse Monica noted that there were number of poor older women living alone who are suffering from depression. So, what is your first goal here? So, in your number 140, that is a common board question, madami lagi nagkakamali dyan kasi ang sinasagot nila is the letter C, reduce the suicide risk daw. Okay? So, that is not your first goal. Okay? That is not your first goal. Your first goal here is to improve the level of function. So, letter D is the correct answer. Okay? So, primary treatment goals for depression include the relief of symptoms and return to effective function. Additional goals include preventing personal and societal effects of the mental health problems and improving the client's and family's quality of life and preventing suicide. So, provision of recreation and entertainment is not identified goal for the client with depression. Okay, so the correct answer here is letter D. That is the primary treatment goal for depression, to return to its effective function. Okay, so next, number 141. Nurse Monica is aware of her nursing responsibilities in promoting mental health. These include the following, except A. Teach parents the importance of community of providing emotional support to their children. B. Increase general knowledge of the community on knowledge on mental hygiene. Or C. Help the community address factors that promote mental well-being. Or D, refer at once cases of bizarre behaviors to a psychiatrist. So take note, we are answering a negative question. So, except kasi yan. So, ang hinahanap natin dyan is negative answer. So, alin dito ang hindi nagpro-promote ng mental health? So, in your promotion of mental health, that is under the primary level of prevention niya. So, nagpro-promote ka ng mental health. So, letter A promotes mental health because you are teaching the community about the importance of your emotional support to their children. Sa letter B naman natin, that is still promotion of mental health, kasi ini-increase mong general knowledge of the community on their knowledge on mental hygiene. And also letter C, helping the community addressing factors that promote mental well-being is a promotion in mental health. So letter D is the exact answer here. So refer at once cases of bizarre behaviors, okay? So have been found. So mali po yun, okay? So letter D is the correct answer. So promoting mental health means increasing the health capabilities and function in the absence of the disease. So primary prevention po yan. So option A, B, and C promotes mental health functioning in order to prevent the actual illness from happening. Yung option D kasi natin, however, it is a secondary prevention na. So since case of bizarre behaviors have been found and needs referral to expert. Okay, so letter D is not a primary level of prevention or not a promotion for mental health, but it is your secondary prevention na. So need na niya ng treatment, kaya nire-refer na natin yan sa expert or sa ating mga facilities. Okay, so the correct answer here is letter D. Okay, so bizarre behaviors have been found and needs referral to experts.